Hey, this is Stephen Christian from Anberlin. Thank you so much for watching Anchor Shop TV.
You came out of nowhere, but who could you hold that horse unstable? Do you still do as you're told? Think you're wild and you're free now. Think you can cover me well.
You have to amalgamate, or you have to at least adapt to everything that's happening around you, such as when we began, Facebook wasn't popular. You know, it was still kind of like one of those college websites where you had to be in college, you know, to have a Facebook account. Twitter wasn't, you know, relevant like it is. And so I think that you kind of flow with technology, you flow with social media, and you definitely just keep adapting to the external, you know, external environment. That doesn't mean that you change your music. You know, you should stay true to whatever the band that, you know, that you're in is. You know, you shouldn't try to change your sound. And, you know, if dance music is cool, you don't drop your members and pick up a record player and try to spin records. I think we would use it if we weren't using it all the time for Anberlin. But since, like, Anberlin takes up so much of our time, you know, whether it's Facebook or Twitter or Tumblr or et cetera, Instagram, we really don't utilize our own social media outlets, just because, you know, when you're on your kind of phone or laptop all day, work, you know, with your band and kind of talking to fans and stuff like that, you kind of, you know, lose track of your own social media. We don't, you know, like you said, we don't measure our success based on album sales at all. I think the biggest measure is how many people are singing along with your new record. You know, I mean, when you go to a show, you know, you look out the crowd, if everybody's just kind of standing there and frozen when you play a new song, you're just kind of like, oh no, this, you know, this isn't good. But this tour hasn't been like that. I mean, it's Vital has totally been accepted well, and people are screaming along just as loud as they would be for Paper Thin Hymns. I'm not sure how other bands do it, but how we do it is, like, we try to divide, we try to make like 60% of the whole set, you know, songs from our past records, and only 40% of the new record from the new record, because I hate going to a show and, you know, this band just put out a new record, I don't know any of the songs, and I only like, you know, two or three of the records because I haven't given the new one a chance. So I definitely kind of, we want to make sure it's split between the, you know, old and new. And then also we want to throw in, we always throw in a curveball, and whether that looks kind of like a cover song, or this time we're playing a B-side off the record, Dark as the Way, called I'd Like to Die. And so we just try to do something for, like, fans, you know, like the real fans. At first it was like the critics' darling. It was like, they're, you know, oh, this is the best Anberlin record anybody, you know, they've ever put out, and, you know, it's, this is the best thing and all this stuff. But the band kind of like took a step back from that, because we were like, it doesn't really matter what the critics say. I think, you know, like I mentioned before, it's the fan reaction that means so much, you know. Critics have been known to be wrong, and also, like, they just, it says, you know, you could have the most critically acclaimed record in the entire universe, but if four people are coming to your show and no one's singing along, it just doesn't matter, you know. So what is the true, you know, test of how well Vital's doing is kind of going on tour and people being there. This is our sixth record, and so we kind of assess, like, why are we still in the band? And it's not because we're having doubts or if we should break up or not like that. It's kind of like, what is our motivation? Like, why are we still here? Why are we still doing this? Why are we, touring 250 days a year and, you know, all over the, just traveling all the time? And we realize, like, it's because we love being on stage. Like, that's our favorite part of being in a band. And our favorite part of any set is when people are just going ballistic. And so that's kind of the record that we wanted to write. We wanted to write an album that we want to play from front to back on stage. You know, we want that raw energy. We want that emotion. We want people just up in arms the entire set. The live setting for me personally is very important. I mean, because I feel like with today's Pro Tools and electronics and keyboards and all this stuff, you know, like, seriously, your nephew could write a number one song. You know, it's just, I'm not trying to take away from anybody who's, you know, been in the, you know, working at it for so long. I'm just stating that, like, it's not, you know, for those people that sat countless hours in their guitars doing scales, you know, and now it's basically like keyboard driven music. For me, I want to go to a show where I, you know, whether it's electronic or not, but I want to, like, I love musicianship. I love talent. I love just the ability. I love watching performances. I love when people are so passionate about what they do. I don't care if they're standing behind a computer DJing or they're shredding. You know, it doesn't matter. I just want to know that they're passionate about it, you know, and I want to be around other people that share that same passion. I can't say that I'm disappointed by anything, because I think there's a place. I think that's the beauty of our kind of, like, culture right this second. Like, you know, like, everybody who calls themselves a musician or a DJ or whatever you want to call it, right now, we are so diversified, and it's awesome. So, you know, there's, you know, a folk revival. There's somebody sitting behind a laptop. There's, you know, this solo artist that just plays the guitar, or this guy that just invented an instrument. And I mean, if you think about it, like, in the 50s to 70s to 80s, if you turn on the radio, you were succumbed by only, like, you know, 20 songs during the day. And there wasn't that many genres. I mean, you had no choice. It was kind of like, you either listen to this or you listen to this. That's it. That's, you know, that's your options. But now it's like, I don't care if you're into techno polka. There is absolutely a band out there. If you want to go to a rave where people are using their voices like guitars and wearing clown outfits, there's definitely a band there, you know? But, and I think that, you know, people get frustrated. They're just like, oh, you know, you use Fruity Loops, and you pushed a key on your keyboard and made some weird noise, and, you know, made it sound like Transformers fighting each other, and call it a genre, but it doesn't matter. Like, that's awesome. Like, that, the fact that, like, that guy, those people, like, out there and have an audience, like, that's great. You know, like, the diversity of what we have now compared, you know, everybody has choices. If you don't like the genres out there, then you just invent one. You just make one. And I think that's the freedom that we have as musicians, as a culture, you know, that we're free to express ourselves or listen to whatever we want. I mean, there's absolutely music out there for everybody now. And and it's only going to expand, you know. I have no idea where music is going to go. I mean, Jim Morrison, if you go back, he actually, from The Doors, he actually said that's the future of music, is somebody sitting behind electronics creating. And that was, to me, I was like, how did he know that? Like, but, like, here we are, you know, what, 40, 30 years later, I don't know how long it's been since The Doors, but I have no idea what the future holds. You know, like, it's just, I mean, it's like, literally it feels limitless, you know, to what the expansion is. I mean, lips that need no introduction. I think it's amazing to have so many people of different, like, just age groups and demographics and races and color, creed, religion. I think it is amazing to be able to look out an audience. I mean, it's funny, because, like, you know, we just started getting played on the radio, like, the last since 2010, you know? And so you can tell the people that come in from the radio. You're just like, oh my God, you're wearing a Harley Davidson shirt, you're a biker, like, literally half drunk. And then here you have, like, this good little Christian kid, you know, and they're all together and they're all just, like, mingling and hanging out. And it's just like, this is awesome. Like, I mean, I think that's what I love about music, or at least playing in this band, is just like it feels like that we've reached so many different people. And it's funny, like, how when people come up and, like, I love this song because, or I was, you know, I really feel like this lyric meant a lot to me because, and all the stories are different. And I think that's such a cool feeling. Never make it, you can't.